we'll start it. Okay, right. So the relation was V is equal to minus G capital M by R. V is equal to minus G capital M by R. It is your gravitational potential, and the value is it is minus 5.12 into 10^7 joule per kg. Now we got the V, and acceleration due to gravity, small g, they have given, it is nothing but gm by r. Okay, small g is nothing but gm by r. Okay, so this is equal to 6.4 meter per second square at the particular height. Now we need to find the radius. So to find the radius, this r is nothing but the total height. So from these two relations, what I'll do, I'll going to divide these two to find the r. So dividing, assume it is the first relation, and assume it is the second relation. Dividing these two. So when you are dividing these two, we'll get the r. Sorry, it is r square. So it is r. R is equal to 5.12 into 10^7, and it is minus of minus will be there. It will be plus divided by 6.4. Okay. When you do it, you'll get the relation as 8 × 10^6 meters. 8 × 10^6 meters. So you can convert into kilometers. It is 8,000 kilometers. It is 8,000 kilometers. Okay. So now we got the relation. Now we need to find the height. So remember the height from the surface of the earth. Okay. From the surface of the earth. So the total height which we got was 8,000 kilometers. Okay. So it is, okay, it is a combination from the base. It is a combination from the base. So this is your radius. So this capital R is 6,400 kilometers. Now we need to find this height. Okay, the total is 8,000. This radius is 6,400. So we need to find this height. So when you want to find this height, so we're just doing 8,000 minus 6,400, we'll get 1,600 kilometers. Always remember, everything we are converting into kilometers only. It's not in meters. Okay, so this is your answer. So check panikonga, whether if you have any issues, you can ask me now. I have to move further. Or here, எப்படி ரெக்கார்ட் பண்ற கொஞ்சம் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணுங்க. நீங்க ரெக்கார்ட் பண்ற பரவாயில்ல நம்ம அங்கே பாத்துக்கலாம்னு சொல்லிட்டு சில பேர் வந்து ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் பண்ண மாட்டேங்கிறீங்க. கொஞ்சம் பாருங்க. ஓகே, ரெக்கார்டிங் ஜஸ்ட் வந்து அது எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் எதுவுமே இல்லை. சம்டைம்ஸ் அது பிரேக் ஆகலாம், சம்டைம்ஸ் நான் வந்து ஸ்கிப் பண்ணலாம், ஏதாவது அது கட் பண்ணிடலாம். ஓகே, எனி இஷ்யூஸ்? கேன் யூ கோ டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன்?
எஸ் சார்.
எஸ் சார்.
ஓகே, சோ நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், எஸ்கேப் வெலாசிட்டி. Escape velocity. Remember, in the escape velocity relation, the Roma important. So we are not going to derive it. We'll see the final equation. Escape velocity and orbital velocity. Okay. So next heading, escape velocity. Okay. Escape velocity. So for example, assume. So it is our Earth. So Earth surface, under what I do now, under an object throw under Earth surface, under. Okay, so at the surface and solum bodhi, either acceleration due to gravity, small g is equal to g capital M by r square. It already number discussed panna. Okay, so this is your radius r. Okay, so in here and what I'll do, I'm just throwing an object upward direction, or object in the upward direction, and idoda field, assume this is your gravitation field. Okay, escape velocity na, when you are throwing an object again and again, then it is skipping this gravitational field. Okay, when it is avoiding the gravitational field and it is moving upward direction, this velocity, whatever the velocity, we call it as escape velocity. This is your escape velocity. Okay, this escape velocity was important relation. So sometimes questions are directly applied. So escape velocity now continuously I am doing some work, throwing an object from surface of the earth to the upward direction, which is escaping the gravitation. Now, so we'll see the relation when we are discussing about the relation. So it is on the point P. I assume this is your x. Okay, so there is a force which is having small mass here, it is capital M. So F is equal to G capital M small m by x square. This is your force, and I am doing some work throwing this object upward direction. So work done is nothing but your change in displacement. So integral F into dx. When you are integrating it, we'll get the final relation. W is equal to it is gm, and remember it is your infinity location and it is your from the r. So there are two limits are there. In the initial condition, it is your final condition. So from this relation, the g capital M small m, it is 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. Okay, from this relation, 1 by infinity is 0. It is g m small m by r. It is your work done. So from this work done, so in the work done, now on the kinetic energy order relate because when we are discussing about the velocity, work and kinetic energy are same. When we are discussing about the potential, work and potential energy are same. Okay, so no need to write it, just understand this picture. So from this relation, we are going to equate to the kinetic energy. From this relation, we are going to equate to the kinetic energy. Equate panumbodhu, we'll get a final relation. Okay, so that final relation, that final velocity is nothing but your escape velocity. So V escape is equal to, square root of 2gm by r. V escape is equal to square root of 2gm by r. Okay, and if you want to convert this relation into small g relation another gm by r square. So when this relation matters, so gm is equal to g into r square. So from this relation, V escape is equal to square root of 2gr. Render relation is important. It is with respect to universal gravitation constant, and this one is related to acceleration due to gravity. Clear? Just take these two relations. Okay. So next one was, when we are discussing the same thing with respect to your densities. Okay. So density related and I discussed panumbodhu. So I'm just converting this one into density. Density relation another, density is equal to mass by volume. So mass is equal to 4/3 pi r³ρ. Okay, mass is equal to 4/3 pi r³ρ, because when you are discussing about the speed. Now, in the mass, and then in the relation, first relation, I substitute. So escape velocity V is equal to square root of 2g, okay, by r into 4/3 pi r³ρ. So the final relation will be, it is a square root of 8 pi, okay, by 3. G rho r square. So this is your escape velocity. This is your third relation. Okay, escape velocity, moon relations will be one universal gravitational constant, small g, and the density relation. Clear? We'll do one problem on this one. In the formula, not one is going. Okay. First formula, first problem. We'll do a problem on this. First problem. Find the velocity of escape. Find the velocity of escape at the earth. Find the velocity of escape at the earth. Given that its radius is 6.4 into 10 power 6 meters. Its radius is 6.4 into 10 power 6 meters. 6.4 into 10 power 6 meters, and value of small g is 9.8 meter per second square. Value of small g is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, I'll repeat again. Find the velocity of escape at the earth given that its radius is 6.4 into 10 power 6 meters, and the value of small g at its surface is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, so you need to find the escape velocity. So இங்க வந்து r கொடுத்திருக்காங்க g கொடுத்திருக்காங்க. So we have to take the relation square root of 2gr. Okay, right. Give me the answer.
Kilometers, sir.
Yes, ma'am. 11.2 kilometer per second. Remember, it is 11.2 kilometer per second. It is your escape velocity. So this is your answer. So those who don't know, just check it. So escape velocity is equal to square root of 2 into g into r. G value kurti tanga. 9.8 kurti tanga into R value kuduthanga. R value vandu 6.4 into 6. When you do the calculation, so it is 11.2 into 10^3 meter per second. So if you want to convert into kilometers, it is 11.2 kilometer per second. This is your answer. Okay. Done. Okay. Next question. Next question. என்னாச்சுமா அது யாருமா பேசுறீங்க கொஞ்சம் மியூட் பண்ணிட்டேங்கம்மா கொஞ்சம் ஓகே ஃபைண்ட் த வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் எஸ்கேப் நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் ஃபைண்ட் த வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் எஸ்கேப் வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் எஸ்கேப் ஃப்ரம் த சன் ஃபைண்ட் த வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் எஸ்கேப் ஃப்ரம் த சன் ஃப்ரம் த சன் கம் இஃப் இட்ஸ் மாஸ் இஸ் If its mass is 1.89 into 10^30 kgs. If its mass is 1.89 into 10^30 kgs and its distance from the earth is 1.59 into 10^8 kilometers. 1.59 into 10^8 kilometers. Capital G is 6.67 into 10^-11 Nm² per kg². Okay, I'll repeat the question. Find the velocity of escape from the sun if its mass is 1.89 into 10^30 kg and its distance from the earth is 1.59 into 10^8 kilometers. Take G is equal to 6.67 into 10^-11 Nm² per kg². Okay, so try it. Again, we got the, we have to find the escape velocity. And if a relation in our square root of root 2 gm by r. Square root of root 2 gm by r. Final answer. Anyone got the answer? Continue பண்ணுங்க இன்னும் இருக்கு ஆன்சர் 3.98 into power terms இருக்கா
yes sir
3.98 into okay so the relation is it is square root of 2 g m by r is equal to square root of 2 into g value so m value r value when you are substituting so the relation will be okay so the answer will be approximate 3.98 into 10^4 meter per second 10^4 meter per second or you can convert 39.8 kilometer per second 39.8 kilometer per second okay this is your answer check பண்ணிக்கோங்க just substitute பண்ணிட்டு you have to calculate it and remember நீங்க calculations பண்ணும்போது power terms கொஞ்சம் consider பண்ணுங்க okay got it got the answer okay ma'am right So next one. So next heading, orbital velocity. Next heading, orbital velocity. So this orbital velocity, escape velocity relations questions on the direct type for law. The questions can be related on the time period, height, it can be. So we'll discuss one more. Okay, done. Okay, next one, orbital velocity. Orbital velocity. So in the orbital velocity, so we'll discuss this. So assume, so there is our Earth, so which is capital M. Okay, so Earth nandu oru satellite nandu we have projected upward direction. So assume idoda radius of the R. Okay, Earth surface nandu we have projected a satellite. In the satellite nandu it was revolving at a height h. Okay, it was revolving around the Earth. It was revolving around the Earth. Okay, so around there. So upward total height n ago, the total height from the Earth center, it is R plus H. In the R plus H height, this mass, which is small m, is going to revolve around the Earth. Now, so when we are discussing about that, when it is revolving, it was gaining some velocity, which was revolving in its own orbit. Okay, the velocity, which is V naught. I'll consider it as V naught, orbital velocity. Escape velocity, now VEM sort of. Okay, now, when it is revolving in its own orbit, okay, V naught. So there are the two type of forces. One, number one, the gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant force relation, the law of gravitational. So F is equal to V capital M small m by the distance between the two masses, which is R plus H whole square. This is one of the force. The number already there. But when the object was revolving in its own orbit, when it is revolving in its own orbit with making a reference point to the radius, so this radius. We called as this force, we called as centripetal force. This force we called as centripetal force, which was revolving in its own orbit. So centripetal force also same F is equal to M V square, that is V naught square by the radius is R plus H. M V square by R. Okay, so it is M V naught square by R plus H. Now from this two relation, equating these two, we'll get the velocity. So from this relation, V naught is equal to, it is a square root of gm by r plus h, the square root of gm by r plus h. Now as usual, now on the small g, so gm is nothing but gr square, but r on the at a particular height irukadnala, so it is acceleration due to gravity at the surface, it will be g. Now on the surface based on relate pattern, g is equal to gm by r square. Okay, so I'm just going to substituting here with respect to the acceleration due to gravity. The final relation is, it is square root of g r square by r plus h, g r square by r plus h, which is equal to, now r common, now r into square root of g by r plus h. It is V naught. It is your relation for escape velocity, and this is with respect to universal gravitational function. These two relations are important. Either r into root of g by r plus h, r into square root of g by r plus h. Okay. Right. So one small thing. So here when we are discussing about the orbital velocity. So in the orbital velocity, when we are discussing with respect to the surface, so that is inge namakku vandu small g theorem, radius theorem. Yaarum pesuringa?
Sir.
Yeah, sir. Why is sir? Inge vandu message pannunga, illana. உங்க வாய்ஸ் பிரேக் ஆயிட்டு இருக்கு, யூ கேன் மெசேஜ் மீ. சிக்னல் இஷ்யூஸ் இருக்குன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். ஸோ எனி டவுட்ஸ்? ஓகே, இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் எனி டவுட்ஸ் ஐ ரிப்பீட் அகே. நோ, ஓகே சார். நெக்ஸ்ட், ஸோ ஹியர் திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் ரிலேஷன். நோ, வென் யூ டிஸ்கஸ், எஸ்மா, யாருமா அது? எனி டவுட்ஸ் ஆன் திஸ்
சார்?
அதே மாதிரி G by R plus H. Total square root. R naught or R? There is no R minus ma. So R into now on the R square irukkadanala I am separating this relation. These are the two relations. Now, assuming. So assuming we already know acceleration due to gravity. For example, enak acceleration due to gravity theriyum. Okay, on the surface on enikla. Okay, so when we are discussing this V naught on the surface, that means the height h is equal to zero. Then V naught is equal to, V naught is equal to, the relation will be V naught is equal to root gr. V naught is equal to root gr. Okay, it is on the surface. Remember, on the surface. Okay, when we are discussing on the surface, the orbital velocity, so g value number theory 9.8, r value theory 6400 kilometers. When you are substituting, so you will get a value, it will be constant on the surface, remember, 7.92 kilometer per second. 7.92 kilometer per second when it is on the surface. Okay, this is one more relation. So this first one, second one, third one, there are three relations are there. So idu vandu universal gravitational force capital G base pani idu small g and idu on the surface. Clear? I'm taking this one. Okay, next relation. Next relation, when we are discussing about the orbital velocity and orbital velocity and escape velocity, idu rendu kena relation paaku. Okay, if you have taken this one, I'll erase it. Done? Over. Yes, sir. Okay. So next one, relation between orbital velocity and escape velocity. Next one, relation between orbital velocity and escape velocity. Okay. Right. So orbital velocity and escape velocity. Orbital velocity relation is, so it is nothing but, remember whatever we have discussed, whatever we are discussing here, orbital velocity, escape velocity, we are discussing on the surface. Okay, we are discussing with respect to the surface only. So from this, V naught is equal to square root of gr. Ippada namma paathirukom on the surface. And adhe maadhiri escape velocity, V is equal to, H on the zero aidum ange, V is equal to square root of 2gr. V is equal to square root of 2gr. When you're taking the ratios, when you're taking the ratios for these two, okay, so VE by V naught, VE by V naught is equal to root 2. Or VE is equal to root 2 V naught. Remember this, root 2, root ku mattum da, 2 ku mattum da root irukku. Ella idhu podadhenga, root 2 into V naught. So VE is equal to root 2 into V naught. Remove this relation. V is equal to root 2 V naught. Okay. Okay, next relation. Suppose on the orbital and the object on the satellite on the, it was revolving. Okay, revolve panumbodhu the complete revolution, the complete revolution. So it was taking some time period. Okay, so on the time period on the related. Okay, so again now on the forces and the velocity based on the discuss panta, I'll give the final relation. The total time period. Okay, the total time period for the satellite to revolve around the Earth, the relation was t is equal to circumference of the orbit. So total circumference of orbit by orbital velocity. By orbital velocity. Okay. So circumference of orbit by orbital velocity. So circumference of the orbit and so on. Remember it was with respect to the height. So it is 2 pi instead of r, it is r plus h by v naught. 2 pi, it is r plus h into v naught. Into v naught. Okay. So I'll give the final relation. So t is equal to, from this, when you're substituting the v naught here, t is equal to 2 pi square root r plus h whole cube by r plus h whole cube by g r square. T is equal to 2 pi square root, the whole square root for r plus h whole cube by g into r square. It is with respect to acceleration due to gravity. It is with respect to acceleration due to gravity. It is your time period. Now, so when we are discussing about the densities, when we are discussing about the densities, so the time relation will be T is equal to, the time relation will be with respect to the densities, T is equal to 2 pi, T is equal to 3 pi into R plus H whole cube by G rho R cube, G rho R cube square. T is equal to square root of 3 pi into R plus H whole cube by G rho R cube. It is a time period for the orbital for the satellite, which it was revolving around the Earth. So time period and orbital velocity and escape velocity. So the things. Clear? So your relation and neither relation. The relations are. Okay, now assume if the time period, so if it was taking time on the surface, so when it was taking time on the surface on Sonangodu, so assuming H is equal to 0. Okay, H is 0 H. When H is equal to 0, the relation will be, remember, it was at a particular height H, it was with respect to density, and third one was H is equal to 0. When H is equal to 0, that is on the surface, the time period T will be, the time period T will be, I can rewrite it as T is equal to 2 pi square root R cube by GM, 2 pi square root R cube by GM. Okay, instead of R cube, now on the end of the GM placed on the now GR square, small GR square substitute, which is equal to, I can rewrite this as 2 pi square root R by G, 2 pi square root R by G. This is your relation when height H is equal to 0. Okay, the time period it was taken on the surface of the Earth. Right? So these three relations, remember this. Suppose உங்களுக்கு வந்து மெமரைஸ் பண்ண முடியல அந்த ஈக்குவேஷன் T is equal to 2 pi by escape velocity, 2 pi into the circumference, that is circumference by orbital velocity, when you are taking it, you'll get the relations. அதுல வந்து நான் கேபிடல் G ரிலேஷன்ஸ் இருக்கு, ஸ்மால் G ரிலேஷன்ஸ் இருக்கு. Okay, now, so we'll take the height. Height. So, it will be the height from the surface of the Earth, where the satellite, okay, was revolving. Okay, we'll take the height. Next one. So height relation, final relation we'll take from this time period only we are going to derive. So height on the h is equal to t square r square small g by 4 pi square whole power 1/3 minus r. Okay, so T square R square small g by 4 pi square whole power 1/3 minus R. It is your height with which it was revolved. Okay, clear? Done? There is one more thing. So when we are discussing over the momentum, so in your momentum, but in the momentum we call it as angular momentum. So the angular momentum L is equal to momentum into radius. So it is momentum m v naught square into r. M v naught square into r. So I'll write this relation in terms of gm. It is square root of g capital M. It is small m. So in the mass on the small m. Small m the revolver. So capital M small m square into r. Capital M, small m square into r, it is your angular momentum. It is your angular momentum. Done? Taking this, we'll do a problem on this, then we'll go to the next concept. Okay, take a problem. Take a problem. Have you taken this one? Is it done? Okay, take the problem.
Yes, sir.
A remote sensing satellite of the Earth revolves in a circular orbit. Remote sensing satellite of the Earth revolves in a circular orbit. Circular orbit. At a height of 250 kilometers. to 50 kilometers above the Earth's surface, at a height of 250 kilometers above the Earth's surface. I'll repeat the question. A remote sensing satellite of the Earth, revolves in a circular orbit at a height of 250 kilometers above the Earth's surface. Full stop. What is orbital speed? And period of revolution of the satellite. So given radius of the Earth is 6.38 into 10 power 6 meters. And acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth is 9.8 meter per second square. So you need to find the orbital speed and you need to find the period of revolution. Okay, try it. So here they have given the relation. I'll read the question again. Those who are joined now. So a remote sensing satellite of the Earth revolves in the orbit at a height of h is equal to 250 kilometers. Okay, above the Earth surface. What is orbital speed and period of revolution? Okay, they have given the radius and small g. So when we are discussing about the orbital speed, the relation, I'll give the relation. V naught is equal to square root of the whole square root for, okay, it is a small g r square by r plus h. And if you want to find the time period, time of revolution, it is a 2 pi r plus h by V naught. So these are your two relations. So try to find the answer. Okay, take the things. Okay, 9427.2 × 10⁻³. Better you can tell me, right? So you are making yourself difficult for writing the answers. Okay, so here the velocity is, orbital velocity, answer under 7.76 kilometer per second. Okay. This is the orbital velocity relation answer. And the time period is 5370 seconds. So, R plus H you have to substitute here. So, when you are taking the square, we will get 7.76 meter kilometer per second. Okay, time period on the same thing. It is 5370 seconds. So check panikonga. Then I note the answers. You can do this. Ah, solinga.
T-value and another one, sir. Shall I take it 3.14 or
22.7? 5370 seconds. 5370 seconds. Over. So we'll see the next question, then we'll go to the next concept. Just take the question, next one. Next question. An artificial satellite. An artificial pi value on the 3.14 ma, or you can take 22/7. Pi value on the, you can take 22/7. Suppose if you are feeling difficulty, na, sometimes now on the LFX soldra. உங்களுக்கு வந்து 3.14 ஏதாவது டிஃபிகல்ட்டினா ஜஸ்ட் டேக் திஸ் பை வேல்யூ அஸ் 22/7 இட் இஸ் யுவர் ரேடியன்ஸ் ஓகே 180 டிகிரிஸ் எல்லாம் போடாதீங்க பை ஸோ இட் இஸ் 22/7 ஆர் யூ கேன் டேக் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் 3.14 போத் ஆர் சேம் ஒன்லி ஓகே 3.14 ஆர் 22/7 ஓகே ஸோ த ஆன்சர்ஸ் ஆர் 7.76 கிலோமீட்டர் பர் செகண்ட் அண்ட் 5370 செகண்ட்ஸ் ஓகே ரைட் ஸோ டேக் த செகண்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் Okay, related to this. Next one. Next question. An artificial satellite circled around the Earth. An artificial satellite circled around the Earth. Circled around the Earth at a distance of an artificial satellite circled around the Earth at a distance of 3,400 kilometers. 3,400 kilometers. Calculate its orbital velocity V naught. Calculate its orbital velocity V naught. Comma. Time period T. Okay, they have given the radius. R is 6,400 kilometers and G is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, same thing. They have given the height. It is 3,400 kilometers. Okay, R we know, G we know. We need to find the orbital velocity and the time period. I'll give the answers. You check for me. So it is value is V naught is 6,400 meter per second. V naught is 6,400 meter per second, and the time period is 9,621 seconds. Okay. Those are doing it. I will take the admission. Have you done it? Okay, so number next one pora ninga answers note panikonga, you can check it later. Okay. Next one. Next heading, energy of satellites. Make the relation, energy of satellites. So ninga the answers note panikonga, you do it later. Energy of satellites. Okay. So when we are discussing about the energies, here are the two types of energies. So we have already discussed. When we are discussing with respect to the energy position, it is your potential energy. Potential energy relation, we have discussed. It is minus G m small m by R. So potential energy is U is equal to minus G small m G capital M small m by R. And same thing, when we are discussing about the kinetic energy, what are the energy we are discussing? These are nothing but your satellite's energy. Kinetic energy, it was gaining some velocity, and the velocity, the, it is your orbital velocity as well. Okay, it is half m v naught square. So the mass is small m here. So half m v naught square. So total energy. Total energy is kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to really add one above the relation will be minus G capital M small m by R plus half m V naught square is equal to the final relation will be it is minus G capital M small m by 2R. It is your total energy, or you can say it as E, total energy of the satellite with which it was revolved. Done. Okay, there is one more thing, one more type of energy we call it as binding energy of the satellite. We call it as binding energy. Theriyuma, anyone knows about the binding energy? Anyone? Okay. ஒரு ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் இல்ல இருக்கீங்களா இல்லையான்னு தெரிய மாட்டேங்குது. Okay. Binding energy.
No sir.
So in the binding energy, yes ma'am. யார் அது? Who is it?
Sir, I am only Venkatesh.
Venkatesh, you are only Venkatesh. Yes, Venkatesh, tell me. இருக்கியான்னு சொல்லிட்டு கன்ஃபார்ம் பண்றியா? Okay. ஏன்னா வந்து நானே தனியா பேசுற மாதிரி இருக்குல்ல, தனியா ரூம்ல நின்றுட்டு. ஓகே, கொஞ்சம் அப்பப்போ ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் பண்ணுங்கப்பா. சரி, பைண்டிங் எனர்ஜினா, ஸோ நதிங் பட் ஸோ நம்ம வந்து ஒரு எனர்ஜி பேஸ் பண்ணி தான் ஒரு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் வந்து ரிவால்வ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கு அரௌண்ட் த எர்த். ஓகே, ஸோ பைண்டிங் எனர்ஜி இஸ் நதிங் பட் அந்த எனர்ஜி வந்து இட் வாஸ் கெயின். ஸோ வாட் எவர் த எனர்ஜி, தட் மீன்ஸ் ஆர்பிட்டால வந்து ரிவால்வ் ஆகிற எனர்ஜின்னு வந்து அவாய்ட் பண்ணிட்டு இட் வில் லீவ் இன் டு த இன்ஃபினிட்டி லொகேஷன். ஆர்பிட்டால ரிவால்வ் ஆயிட்டு இருக்கும்போது ஸோ இட் வாஸ் எஸ்கேப்பிங் த ஆர்பிட். ஓகே, அண்ட் இட் வாஸ் லீவிங் டு த இன்ஃபினிட்டி. ஓகே, ஸோ லீவிங் த ஆர்பிட் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் யுவர் பைண்டிங் எனர்ஜி. ஓகே, அந்த மூமெண்ட்ல வந்து டோட்டல் எனர்ஜி இ என்ன ஆகும், இ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ ஆகும். டோட்டல் எனர்ஜி இ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ ஆகும். ஓகே, ஸோ இங்கே டோட்டல் எனர்ஜி ரிலேஷன் வி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு மைனஸ் ஜி கேபிட்டல் எம் ஸ்மால் எம் பை டூ ஆகும். ஓகே, ஸோ டோட்டல் எனர்ஜி இ வந்து மைனஸ் ஜி எம் கேபிட்டல் ஸ்மால் எம் பை டூ ஆகும். So if we are gaining the extra energy, that means it was gaining the extra energy. And the extra energy da we call it as binding energy. Appo da it was escaping your orbit. So on the binding energy da, so the relation will be G capital M small m by 2R. That is, it was giving a positive energy. Okay, then only the total energy at this condition, E is equal to 0. Okay, so binding energy relation is B is equal to G mm by 2R. G mm by 2R. Escaping to the infinity from the orbit. Escaping to the infinity from the orbit. Okay, so these are your relations. Binding energy on the positive, total energy on the negative. Remember the relations. Okay. So in the last one, Kepler's laws. So after that, we'll do one problem and we'll stop it. Okay, Kepler's laws. Kepler's laws, anyone? Kepler's laws. So how many laws are there? Don't say it again. First law, second law, third law. Sorry. தெளிவாதான் இருக்கீங்க நீங்க. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லா,
லா ஆஃப் ஆர்பிட்ஸ்.
லா ஆஃப் ஆர்பிட், சூப்பர் மா. எஸ், செகண்ட் ஒன்
லா ஆஃப் ஏரியா.
எஸ் மா, லா ஆஃப் ஆர்பிட்,
டைம் பீரியட்.
லா ஆஃப் பீரியட்,
டைம் பீரியட்.
லா ஆஃப் பீரியட்ஸ், லா ஆஃப் ஏரியாஸ், அண்ட் தேர்ட் ஒன்
லா ஆஃப் பீரியட்ஸ்.
Okay, so law of orbit, a simple problem. Law of orbit, remember, so that whatever the planet or whatever the satellite, it was revolving around the sun. Okay, it was revolving in its own orbit as well. So we can say that it is nothing but your angular momentum. It is nothing but your angular momentum. So angular momentum another, L is equal to mvr. So angular momentum, it was revolving in its own orbit, it will be constant. Okay, it will be constant always. Angular momentum on the always constant. Okay, now second one, law of areas. Law of areas na, the orbit la revolve agumbodhu it was taking the constant time period, that is constant displacement, constant time period lo it was fading. So on the orbit la undu eppadi venala irukku, okay, in the position when it will try to take the constant areas with respect to the time period. So law of areas on the del A by A, that means a change in area with respect to time period. Change in area with respect to time period is constant. Okay, and the period based on the area. So on the position in the area, it will be always constant. Remember, it is your angular momentum, it is your area with respect to the change in time. Okay, law of periods. Law of periods. So we have seen the time period for the satellite which was revolving around the earth and so to discuss. So when you see that, so it is nothing but T square is proportional to R cube. T square is proportional to R cube. Okay, time period T square is proportional to R cube. And we can say we can take the constant also. I'll give the final relation for this one. Okay, T is equal to, there is an inequality. T is equal to KR cube, which is equal to KR cube, which is equal to 4 pi square by GEM into R cube. 4 pi square GM into R cube. So this is your total relation for the time period. Now on the derivation cellular number problem. So remember T square is proportional to R cube. Okay, so it is your law of periods. So law of orbits, law of areas, and law of periods. Or else you can mention it as your angular momentum, change in area with respect to time. So here change in area, and here time period is proportional to your R cube. Okay, these are your Kepler's laws. Okay, remember the relations. And when you're taking the ratios, in the Kepler's law, time period in a ratio punting now, so it is T2 by T1, for example. Okay, so T2 square by T1 square is equal to R2 cube by R1 cube. You may give questions on this. Okay, T2 square by T1 square is equal to R2 cube by R1 cube. Okay, time period on the, it was in seconds, R on the, it is in meters. Clear? Okay, we'll do one problem on this after the time stop it. Okay, as a problem, gravitation over. Then we'll start your properties. Inikundur chinna topic problem because we have only half an hour. Sir, full board is not able to see. Na shift pandra ipo. So those are having issues with the board, please let me know. And on the ungala position eppadi irukku nu enak theriy maatengudhu. Now is it okay? Is it clear?
Yes.
Nandini, clear ah irukuma? Okay sir, done. Okay, take the question. The distance of two planets from the sun are 10 power 13 meters, 13. I'm just erasing it. Okay. Okay, right. The question was the distance of the two planets from the sun are 10 power 13 meters and 10 power 12 meters. 10 power 13 meters and 10 power 12 meters. Find the ratio of the time periods. And the speeds of the two planets. We need to find the speed and we need to find the time periods. Okay, the ratios find it. Okay, so that means you can take this one as R1 is 10 power 13 and R2 as 10 power 12. Okay, what we need to find? We need to find the ratios. So ratios, another, I'll take T2 by T1 or T1 by T2. I'll take T1 by T2. So T1 square by T2 square is equal to R1 square, R1 cube by R2 cube. It is the first one. Second one relation, we need to find the velocity also. Velocity is related to time period. Number one, the velocity relate to the Munana path. Time period T is equal to the circumference by velocity speed and so on. So T is equal to 2 pi r by velocity. R, if you want to find the velocity, V is equal to 2 pi r by T. So if you want to find the velocity V1, so V1 is nothing but 2 pi r1 by T1, and V2 is equal to 2 pi r2 by T2. Okay, again we need to find the ratios V1 by V2 and T1 by T2. So in the end of the find it one. So these are your relations. Okay, try to find it. So I'll give the answers also. In a join IT, ethanol boring, 1 3 months. 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, you know, 1:30 work, 1:30. And you can do full strength theory. ஆனா வந்து அட்டெண்டன்ஸ் எடுக்கும்போது ஃபுல்லா நைட்டு 12 மணி வரைக்கும் அட்டெண்டன்ஸ் கொடுத்துட்டே இருக்காங்க. யாரானே தெரியல, அவங்க அட்டெண்டன்ஸ் கேட்கறாங்க, நீங்க அட்டெண்டன்ஸ் கொடுங்க. ஓகே ரைட்மா. So answers, I'll give the answers. For the time period ratios, for the time period ratios, it is, answer is 10 root 10. Time period ratios on the 10 root 10. And velocity ratios on the 1 by root 10. Velocity ratios on the 1 by root 10. So answers check panikom. Check the answers. Got it, sir. Okay. Raj, என்ன ராஜ் ஏதோ பேசுறது ட்ரை பண்றீங்க, கிளியரா இல்ல எனக்கு. Or? Got it, sir. Okay. Sir, solid, sir. Could not understand. Okay. Solid. Yes, ma. Yaar, madhu.
V1 by V2 equal to 1 by root 10. Is it correct, sir?
Yeah. Correct, sir. Correct, sir. 1 by root 10, then, sir. Okay, Shubha, I'll solve it. Okay, those who didn't understand, just see the relations. Okay. First one, we'll find the time period. So, R1 is equal to 10 power 13 meters and R2 is equal to 10 power 12 meters. This is your relations they have given. So, we need to find the time period. So, in time period, what I'll do, I'll take the relation from the Kepler's law, T1 by T2 is equal to R1 cube by R2 cube, that is square. P1 square by T2 square is equal to R1 cube by R2 cube. Now, in the square, I need to find T1 by T2 alone. So, it is R1 and 10 power 13 by 10 power 12. So, power terms 3 by 2. Power terms 3 by 2. So, when you do the power terms, it will add the panetric. So, if you add the panetric. So, when you see the regressions, it is nothing but, so it is now, the relations, we can write this one as, suppose ungalku varala power terms varlana, you can write it as 1 plus 1 by 2. Okay, you can write it as 1 plus 1 by 2. So, it will be 10. It will be 10. So, 10 power 1 plus 1 by 2. So, that is power terms add it, that means it was multiplying. So, 10 into root 10 is your answer. Okay, 10 into root 10 is your answer. This is the first one. Clear, Shubha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma. So now we'll see the velocities. So I'll try to find V1 and V2. V1 and V2 tani tani panna vena. So we'll find the direct relation. Ratios matunda enakku venum. Matha terms vandu cancel aayidum idhula. So V1 by V2 is equal to, so relations another V1 is nothing but 2 pi R1 by T1 by 2 pi R2 by T2. So pi will get cancelled, 2 pi, 2 pi will get cancelled. So the relation will be R1 by R2 into T2 by T1. This is V1 by T2. Okay, now, so the relations. So when you are taking the relations like this, so is it clear? I am erasing this one. So, inge T2 by T1, we already know the relation. So it is R1 by R2 into T2 by T1. I'll write in the terms of R itself. So it is R2 by R1 whole power T by 2. R2 by R1 whole power 3 by 2. So when you inverse it, minus 1 or when you inverse it, it will be minus 1. So, okay, it is R2 by R1 whole power minus 1. It is R2 by R1 whole power 3 by 2. So when you do the power terms addition, because the basis are same, R2 by R1 whole power 1 by 2. R2 by R1 whole power 1 by 2. So now R2 another 10 power 12 by R1 10 power 13. Okay, whole power 1 by 2. So when you cancel it, it will be 10. So the relation will be 1 by 2, 10. This is your answer. Okay. Clear? Okay. Right. So till there, the gravitation relations, so these relations are important. Questions on the repeat IT, formulas important, direct questions almost were. Okay. So, any doubts on this? And ma'am, actually, Nathan, a video path again, actually, or video or part material of the chemistry. Ma'am was suggesting about some MTG books. Correct? So, anyone having MTG books with you? In the time, you have MTG books.
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Right. So others, those who don't know, actually on the Naina plan panitrikana, as usual, on the videos and worksheets, I plan to give you individually login ID password, in order personal. Okay, in order website, login ID password. So that's on the upload panel. Actually, number on the classes, all topics, all details on the step by step, and solve panitrikumuria. It will take more time. PDF, sir. Okay, good. PDF in the low. What I'll do, engitte vande Allen books, Akash books, some quota. So there are other books also there. And MTG books also there. Okay. So then I engitte vande PDF from biochemistry, physics, ellame irukke engitte. So what I'll do, adu vande na WhatsApp la share panna mudiyadhu. Oru oru book vande around MTG first part, like for example, class 11th, oru part vande it was around 200 MB. WhatsApp la na share panna mudiyadhu. What I'll do, na vandu individual or login ID passwords na kuduthirren neenga ungalku. So for limited time period da adu panna mudiyum. Okay, so you can go through that. Okay, so adula vandu ella subjects irukum. Okay, ella documents, ella worksheets irukum. Neenga practice pandrathu mattum dhaan irukku. Okay, neenga practice pannanumna I'll share it. Illa paravaillada sir, neenga kuduthala vesa dhaan namaga panna maatom avadhu dhaan sonna, it's up to you. Okay, so enakku oru 2 to 3 days time kudunga. And try to upload it and I'll share it to you. So individually, adu vandu unga login, that means unga name irukum, unga login ID and unga individual password. Okay, yaarukku share pannikadinga adula. Okay, neenga adula download pannikala, you can read there itself and you can upload some books also if you want. Okay, so na edavad worksheets irundha edavad details irundha na ellame upload pannite irukken. Okay, right ma'am. So we'll go to the next one, next concept. So gravitation till that is your relations. Gravitation romba important da. And easiest chapter, so direct number score panda and the formulas want to memorize panikonga, direct practice panada MTG based one. Okay, next one. So this concept was your volume 2 NCERT ER. Okay sir, we'll do it. So NCERT ER kit, they know that volume 2 we'll discuss about the properties of bulk matter. In the properties of bulk matter, we'll discuss about the expansion. Okay, so solids, properties of solids. We'll discuss about the properties of solids. In the properties of solids, and next case on the properties of fluids. Okay, right. So first one, we'll go from the properties of solids. Now, when we're discussing about the units and dimensions, number starting the units and dimensions, we discuss it. Adale, we have discussed about some stress and strain, if you remember that. Stress and strain pathi namba discuss panitom. Okay, so what is stress and what is strain? Anyone? And what are the units? Anyone?
Stress is force per area.
Okay, good. Why we cannot say it is a pressure? Yeah, pressure and solid would have force per area, pressure and the same thing.
Stress is the term used in place of solids.
Yes, ma'am. Stress, we will discuss distress related things in solids. Pressure related things we'll discuss in fluids. Fluids related air irukalam, that is your gases or your liquids. Gases, liquids pathi namba discuss pannumbodhu, it is a pressure. Okay. Then what is strain and what is its unit?
Change in size.
Strain is the rate change in dimension by original dimension and it has no unit.
Yes.
No unit.
Yes, ma'am. It is a ratio. It is a ratio. So we can say that strain is nothing but change in configuration. Yes, ma'am. Change in configuration. Change in configuration by original configuration. So the length, volume, area, configuration. When there is a ratio, there are changes, there are no units and there are no dimensions. It is a ratio. Okay. So simple relation with respect to length. So strain is equal to change del L by N. Okay. Here there is no ratio. And when we are discussing about the area also, del A by A, volume also, del B by B. Okay, there are no areas. There is no unit and there is no dimension. Okay, so you already know about the stress and strain. Can anyone tell me what is rigid body? Rigid, R-I-G-I-D, rigid body.
Rigid body is a body which doesn't change state or shape under any external force.
Yes. Yes, yes. Without even though when we are applying an external forces, this body doesn't change at all. So that means it doesn't show any deformation. Doesn't show any deformation. Okay. So without any deformation, even though we are applying some external forces, okay, we call it as rigid body. Okay. If there is any change, if there is any change when you are applying some external forces, what we call it as deforming forces, it will be different cases. Okay, the rigid, those are nothing but non-rigid bodies. Those non-rigid bodies are nothing but your elastic and plastic. Okay, those non-rigid bodies are called, is called elastic and plastic bodies. Okay, elastic and plastic bodies. So in the relation that we are going to discuss about, if you remember that, number the work and energy, the elastic and perfectly inelastic and certain number discuss panirko when we are discussing about the collisions. Okay, elastic na it will bounce back with the same force which you are applying. Perfectly inelastic na the upper stick cut it will try to travel. Okay, same case is same. So here we'll discuss with respect to deforming forces. So the elastic lane of na it will try to bounce back when we are applying some force. Okay, but plastic collision, plastic lane of na, so when you are applying some force, it will not regain its original position, it will change its shape. Okay, plastic, elastic, they will be having some graph. In the deformation, we will discuss. Okay, so one by one, we will see. So here, first of all, we will see the types of stress. Okay, note it down. On the theory, I will give the headings, other relations. So first one, take it as stress types. Types of stress. First one, normal stress. Normal stress. Second one, tangential stress. Tangential stress. Normal stress, tangential stress. Tangential stress symbol, I can clear it as, I can say it as shearing stress. S-H-E-A-R-I-N-G. Shearing stress. Shearing stress. So normal stress and shearing stress. Okay. So normal stress again splitted into types. Normal stress again split into types. So one we call it as tensile stress. We call it as tensile stress. Second one, compressive stress. Compressive stress. And third one, it is your hydraulic stress. Hydraulic stress. Okay. So normal stress in the three parts split are the tensile, compressive, and hydraulic. Okay, and tangential or shearing stress. Okay, so normal stress. Normal stress. Anyone? What is normal stress?
It acts against the gravitation.
Hey, நம்ம கிராவிடேஷன் பத்தி நம்ம விட்டுட்டோம்டா, கிராவிடேஷன் முடிஞ்சிடா, நம்ம ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் சாலிட்ஸ் டிஸ்கஸ் பண்றோம், விட்டுட்டு கிராவிடேஷன். Okay, so stress, remember whatever we are discussing here, we discuss deforming forces. We are discussing about the deforming force. Yaar madhe innu gravitation la da irukanga. நான் பார்க்கல நேம் வெங்கடேஷா சிவகுமார்
the stress applied perpendicularly
here we are not discussing about the perpendicular part okay so normal stress is nothing but so when we are applying a deforming force so what are the forces applying normally okay so over a body okay and it will regain its original position so when it is regaining its original positions what are the stress we are applying we call it as normal stress whatever the deforming forces we are applying we call it as normal stress in the normal stress on the three things tensile compressive and hydraulic tensile stress na it was with respect to your length okay so it was with respect to your length increasing length remember increasing length tensile stress na it was your increasing length okay and when you are releasing what will happen it will regain its original position and compressive strength it was your decreasing length compressive na it was your decreasing length okay right hydraulic stress na it was change in its volume hydraulic stress na you can change in its volume okay and remember tensile or compressive stress both combinedly or separately we can call it as longitudinal stress because we are related with respect to the length we call it as longitudinal stress okay na romba rush panna maten slow ah kolam so stresses on the normal stress irukku tangential or shearing stress we can say it as and normal stress on the three parts irukku tensile compressive and hydraulic so tensile stress was increasing length compressive stress was decreasing length okay and tensile compressive we can say this was as longitudinal so it is combinedly kadai tani taniya we can say it is longitudinal because it was related to your length and hydraulic stress was your change in its volume okay so this is your relations under normal stress okay so here tangential or shearing stress undu edavadhu nama force undu tangential point la nama discuss pandrom we are applying some force on tangential on the surface okay so because of the tangential force on the object on the shape change aichina when the object shape changes okay adula volume base panirukla area base panirukla we call it as tangential stress or shearing stress when you are applying some force tangentially on the surface of the body okay so this is your tangential stress okay so just take the types clear we'll go to the next one okay so next one your strain relation is change in configuration or we can say change in dimension by original dimension change in dimension by original dimension okay it is strain okay so when we are discussing about the strains idhula vandu three parts irukku when we are discussing about the strain idhula three parts irukku so first one longitudinal again it was related to your length only longitudinal strain volumetric strain and the third one we'll discuss as shearing strain and the three longitudinal strain volumetric strain and shearing strain okay right so idhula relations so idhu vandu length based panni varadunala change in length by original length which is longitudinal volumetric na change in volume by original volume shearing na shearing aayittu so longitudinal just take it as del l by l change in dimensions or change in length by original length and here change in volume by original volume just take this one and shearing na solra done okay shearing strain enna so I told you shearing stress tangential stress ansolirken suppose shearing strain parna assume there is a book okay or else there are ஏதாவது ஒரு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இருக்கு okay book ஏ நெச்சுக்கணும் what will do tangential position லோ I'm applying some force tangential position லோ I'm applying some force so assume for example if there are total length side on the l okay from this one so now the when you are applying a tangential forces acting on it what will happen either at both ends it will try to okay bend making some angles it will try to bend making some angle theta okay either a length and the changes which is small l either length changes which is small l when making an angle theta here okay so here because of the tangential forces this object was trying to bend making some angle theta so if you see the relation so shearing stress direct relation I'll give you theta is equal to it was making an angle theta here okay so it is nothing but your change this change is nothing but small l so this change is nothing but small l so it is small l by capital theta is equal to small l by capital small l by capital next one Hooke's law next one Hooke's law Hooke's law so hooke's law is nothing but stress is proportional to strain hooke's law is nothing but stress is proportional to strain so idhula da different types irukku so stress is proportional to strain okay so that means if stress kurta da there will be a change in length and change in volume change in areas so this relation we call as hooke's law So Hooke's law and there is one more thing so when we are discussing about the work and energy adula undu namba spring pathi namba discuss panirukom spring enna na so initially idu displacement of x when we are applying some force in one direction so enna avu it will try to stretch appo displacement change aagum when we are applying some force compress panumbodhu adula displacement change aagum when I release it it will regain its original position adula force is proportional to x nu solli discuss panirukom this force is nothing but kx k is your spring constant and it negative edukodudna because of the opposite direction where the spring was extending okay so regain social position force in opposite direction la it will regain so adanal it was minus so again this is nothing but your Hooke's law okay this is also Hooke's law again if you see that inga vand displacement x change aayirukku because of the force applied so it is your stress and it is your strain so stress is proportional to strain you can remember this relation Hooke's law stress is proportional to strain now inge vand proportional irukku so we have to equate it when you are equating there will be having some proportionality constant okay so stress is equal to k into strain stress equal to some k into strain this k we call it as modulus of elasticity okay so we call it as modulus of elasticity you can note down modulus of elasticity so in the modulus of elasticity இது வந்து 3 टाइप्स ஆ ஸ்ப்ளிட் பண்ணிருக்காங்க modulus of elasticity வந்து 3 टाइप्स ஆ ஸ்ப்ளிட் பண்ணிருக்காங்க so இது வந்து I can write it as k is equal to stress by strain k is equal to stress by strain okay so this k we call it as modulus of elasticity this k we call it as modulus of elasticity okay right so இதுல வந்து 3 टाइप्स இருக்கு Done. Have you taken this one? Just a running notes la vechukonga. Na vandu dictate pandra maari venum. Idhu vandu concept idhu dhaan. Idhe relations dhaan na vandu box la vechirken. Okay. Clear? Types paakalam. So modulus of elasticity moon type irukku idhula. Modulus of elasticity la moon type irukku. First one.
Bulk modulus.
Young's modulus. Yes ma correct. Young's modulus. Second one, now spelling pandra, those who don't know, they can write it here. They can note it down. Young's modulus, Y-O-U-N-G-S. Young's modulus, M-O-D-U-L-U-S. There are symbol and the Y. Young's modulus, Y. Bulk modulus, B. Third one, rigidity modulus, or modulus of rigidity. R-I-G-I-D-I-T-Y. Rigidity modulus, capital G. Okay, Young's modulus, bulk modulus, rigidity modulus. Rigidity modulus related to a shearing or tangential. Okay, Young's modulus relation on the, so it is nothing but normal stress. Na shortcuts use pandra. Normal stress by, apdi running notes note panni vechukonga. So I'm just dictating it one by one. Running notes are vechukonga. So Young's modulus is equal to normal stress by longitudinal strain, normal stress by
actually வந்து ஒரு இஷ்யூ ஆயிடுச்சு ஏன் சைட் வந்து இதான் இஷ்யூ கேக்குதா வாய்ஸ் கிளியரா இருக்கா ஹலோ கொஞ்சம் நெட்வொர்க் இஷ்யூஸ் இருக்கு நவ இஸ் இட் கிளியர் கேன் யூ அபிள் டு சீ மீ ஐ மீன் கேன் யூ அபிள் டு சீ தி வோர்ட்
சார்
வாய்ஸ் கிளியரா இருக்கு ஓகே சார் ரைட் சோ வில் கண்டினியூ பண்ணலாம் கொஞ்சம் நெட்வொர்க் இஷ்யூஸ் இருந்தது ஓகே சோ First one, Young's modulus and solar. Young's modulus on the, it is normal stress by longitudinal strain. Normal stress by longitudinal strain. It is your Young's modulus. It is your Young's modulus. So other relations talk about it. Normal stress, now remember, stress and solar is force by area. So normal stress relation on the, force by area by longitudinal strain is nothing but del L by L. Del L by L. Which is equal to F by A into L by del L. F by A into L by del L is your Young's modulus relation. Again, either unit. Unit பார்க்கும்போது L by del L is nothing but it was cancelled. It was a ratio. So again, unit only force by area depend on it. The unit is Newton per meter square. Okay, modulus of elasticity, one unit which is Newton per meter square. Remember this equation. Okay. Stress unit is Young's modulus, bulk modulus, rigidity modulus. Clear? Next one. Second one, bulk modulus. Second one, bulk modulus. Bulk modulus, again, normal stress by volumetric strain. Bulk modulus on the normal stress by volumetric strain. Normal stress by volumetric strain. Bulk modulus B is equal to normal stress by volumetric strain is equal to normal stress again it is nothing but force by area volumetric strain is nothing but it is del V by B. So I can write it as F by A into V by del V is your bulk modulus. Okay, V by del V is your bulk modulus. Okay, right. Suppose bulk modulus la namba volume pathi discuss panumbodhu suppose inge vandu if it was increase in its volume okay volume based discuss panumbodhu na vandu pressure ku relate pandren sometimes okay so bulk modulus B is equal to suppose idu fluids ku relate agumbodhu da suppose if you are getting the questions so here there will be some negative minus P V by del V minus P V by del V okay minus pv by del v so this negative sign indicates you can mention minus also here this negative sign indicates you can write it there negative sign indicates increase in pressure negative sign indicates increase in pressure comma decrease in volume increase in pressure decrease in volume increase in pressure decrease in volume so inge vandu if you remember pv is equal to nrt gas equation so pressure and volume both are inversely proportional pressure increase aichuna volume decrease aagum pressure decrease aichuna volume increase aagum so remember this relation okay so on the opposite term irukadanal we are taking it as minus when we are discussing about the pressure okay and the third one in the third one solita I'll stop it here so after that I'll give some problems to you homework okay so third one, your modulus of rigidity or rigidity modulus. The symbol on the capital G. G is equal to tangential stress by. Yaar madhu? Who is that? Okay, that issue is irukka. Right, okay. Not done. So, tangential stress by shearing strain. Tangential stress by shearing strain. Tangential stress by shearing strain. So it is nothing but it is F by A shearing strain than theta and solar. So F by A by small L. F by A into L by that is L by small L. Okay. Again, the unit is nothing but your Newton per meter square.
okay newton per meter square so I'll stop till this okay so idhula vandu or graph irukku after that namba vandu we have to discuss about the Poisson's ratio after that idhula relations irukku so the unit will be over chinna unit da so tomorrow we'll complete this one okay we'll give some homework ore or question on homework kudukuren just try to practice it okay so varlana tomorrow we'll discuss it just take the question okay just take the question a rope 1 cm in diameter a rope 1 cm in diameter breaks if the tension in it exceeds 500 newtons a rope 1 cm in diameter sorry ma'am
sir breaks or takes sir
okay breaks I'll repeat again a rope 1 cm diameter breaks if the tension is 500 newton if the tension is 500 newton okay so the maximum tension that may be given to a similar rope the maximum tension that may be given to a similar rope of dia 2 cm of dia 2 cm so that means for 1 cm maximum tension is 500 newtons up to 2 cm ko what is the tension options are so it is 500 newtons second one 250 newtons third one 1000 newtons and fourth one it is 2000 newtons so these are your options a b c and d okay I'll repeat the question a rope of 1 cm breaks if the tension exceeds 500 newtons okay the maximum tension that may be given to the similar rope of 2 cm okay we need to find the tension for the similar rope of 2 cm okay so this is your question so try to find it so tomorrow we'll discuss okay any doubts so far